In the 90s, when I retired in 93, I thought, well, I've got this one car and I got four kids. That's not going to work very well. So I decided, well, why don't we just build another one? So there was an ad in the paper from a guy in West Des Moines, had a garage like this, and he had two of these cars in there in pieces. The body was in two halves, the front half and the back half, and there was no middle, but he had the doors and everything. And the other car was all together, but it was really rusted out and the bottom was all rotted out. And so I offered him $3,200. Oh, no, he says, I'll take him to California and piece him out. That can get a lot more money there. So a year later, or two, I can't remember, a year later, I got a call from this boy's dad, and he says, you still want those cars? So I said, yeah. So I went and picked them up and brought them all over here. And so now, hey, I've got three cars, see? I only need one more.
Someone found him.
And he called me one day and said, hey, I got a guy that wants to sell his project. So I said, oh, I'll go look at it. Okay, he wanted $900 for it. I just said, oh, okay, that's not bad. So that got me the next one, and then the next one was, it was another project car. They had two project cars. And then the last one was, a guy got a hold of me. He says, I have a car that I'm trying to sell. So I went and looked at it, and it was, it had been in a barn out in Stuart, Iowa, just south of Stuart. We went out there, looked at it. This was in the middle of the winter when he called me. He says, you can't see it right now. I can't get the barn open. So when it melted out, we went out and looked at it. He had drug it out into the field, and it was pretty well rusted away, but it was all the parts were there, but not all right there. A lot of the parts were in a chicken coop. So anyway, I looked them all around. Yeah, I think we can get all the parts. So he wanted $1,000. Okay, so I gave him that. That was the last one.